2005 has been a hallmark year for Beryl, with our client base growing from 300 to 400, the number of employees growing from 200 to 260, and revenue growing from 17 million to 21 million in just 12 short months. Change has been the name of the game here at Beryl, and you know that no one is more excited than CEO Paul Spiegelman.
I am really excited.
2005 also brought us our 20th anniversary and first ever Beryl Family Day, where employee family members got to join in the Beryl fun. We also received our third consecutive Best Places to Work award, converted the old break room into the lounge, acquired 40 new clients with FCG, and added many new members to our management staff. Yes, 2005 was the best year ever. But what does 2006 have in store for us?
2006 is going to be the best year ever. This last year, we know we've had some, well, growing pains. But we've listened to your comments, and we're committed to making sure that every Beryl employee is a happy employee. Let me start by reading some letters I've recently received. Dear Paul, how come we can't use cell phones in the bathroom? To get to the core of this new policy, we decided to go into the women's bathroom and interview one of our coworkers to see what she thinks. Hey, what do you think of the new cell phone policy?
Paul, can I get some private privacy in here?
Let's go on to the next question. Hi, Paul. Boy, I sure love collecting demographics. People are so willing to give us that information. Can we do more of this, please? Actually, yes. Eric has been working with our quality assurance department to make sure we're collecting every piece of useful information for our clients. After all, that's what makes the Beryl difference.
Do you prefer red onions or green onions?
Yes, sir. If it's 3 p.m. in New York, what time is it in Tokyo?
Yes, sir. Station wagons holds a lot of stuff. Do you agree or disagree? Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. And if a tree falls down in a forest, does it make a sound? Okay, thank you.
Okay, yes. And who's your daddy?
And sir, could you tell me how many fingers I'm holding up at this current time? Oh, I'm sorry, sir. That was incorrect.
And name something blue. Like, for instance, a shirt.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather be stranded on an island or in space? But we need to know those answers in order to finish this call.
That's fine.
Island?
Hey, Paul. Have you noticed that as the business gets bigger, this building gets smaller? Yes, I've noticed that. We've been researching several options, and we decided to let you, our employees, determine what your preference is. So I'm going to name off some choices, and through your applause, we're going to determine which one we use. The first choice is option A. That would be to move into Suite C next door. Option B is open up more offices closer to where the employees live. Option C, work from home. Option D, how about we add another layer of cubicles above the ones we have? Okay, next question. Dear Paul, are we going to be getting on-site childcare ever? Well, I'm happy to announce that in January 2006, Beryl will have on-site childcare.
Welcome to New York Presbyterian Hospital. My name is Deborah Rudolph. How may I help you? Yes, I'll be glad to assist you. Yes.
Okay, next question. Why do we still have a business casual dress code? Over the last few years, our dress code has actually become more casual. In fact, we're noticing a trend that the more casual our dress code, the happier our employees. In the last 3 years in the Best Places to Work survey, relaxed dress code was the number one reason our employees are happy. So we've made an important decision. We're going to eliminate the current dress code and come up with a new one. It's called Relaxed.
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. Lamppost, what you knowin'? I come to watch your flowers growin'. Ain't you got no rhymes for me? Do it and do do, feelin' groovy. Da 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 da, feelin' groovy.
Paul, what happened to the patio? The patio. Seen better days, hasn't it? Problem is, it's outside. And we can't control what happens outside. But since it's used primarily as a smoking area, we've decided that in 2006, we're going to open up a smoking section on the call center floor. Dear Paul, the gong show was fun. Can we do more things like that? We do love our versions of game shows, don't we? Think about it. In 2004, we had Survivor. Every year, we do the Gong Show, and even our training department does Jeopardy. So, by popular demand, in 2006, we're introducing several new shows. First, Beryl Fear Factor. Second will be the 2006 Beryl World Series of Poker. Finally, Beryl Extreme Dodgeball. Here comes Johnny in again with liquid dogs and a cash machine. He's gonna do another striptease. Hey man, where'd you get that lotion? I've been hurting since I. And finally, we want to show you the most exciting thing for 2006. In 2006, we're investing $6 million to build a replica of me so that I can become twice as productive, and because it's kind of cool. Meet RoboPaul.
I'm Paul Spiegelman, CEO of the Beryl Companies.
How cool is that? Now, dance, robot.
We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to. Places they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world. Leave the real one far behind. Night is young and so am I. And we can dress real neat from our hearts to our feet and surprise them with a victory cry. Say, we can act if we want to. If we don't, nobody will. And you can act real rude and totally removed, and I can act like an imbecile. Say, we can dance, we can dance. Everything's out of control. We can dance, we can dance. We're doing it from pole to pole. We can dance, we can dance. Everybody look at your hands. We can dance, we can dance.